Hello, this video is about Zeno's paradoxes. These paradoxes are related to the limits of our physical universe. So let's understand them and talk about the solutions for these paradoxes. The first paradox we're going to talk about that's attributed to Zeno of Elea is the Achilles paradox. It's basically a race between Achilles and a tortoise. So because the tortoise is really slow, they give a head start for the tortoise. But the thing is, when they both start running, let's say that the tortoise is 100 meters ahead of Achilles, but when both start, let's say that the Achilles reach where the tortoise was, so it reached the tortoise position, but the tortoise is also moving, so it's when Achilles get here, the tortoise moved a little bit further. So again, Achilles tried to reach the tortoise, so it runs more, he keeps running, and when he reaches the tortoise position, again the tortoise will have moved a little bit further, and it keeps going infinitely. So according to Zeno, Achilles would never get the tortoise, because every time he reaches the tortoise, the position it was before, the tortoise would be moved a little bit further. So that's the paradox. We know that in real life, of course, a man or anyone who's running after a tortoise will reach and pass the tortoise. But if you think in this way, well, Achilles would never get to the tortoise. So let's analyze this movement here, okay? So let's say that Achilles, because, well, he's a semi-god, right? He's running at 100 meters per second, okay? And the tortoise is a very special tortoise. The tortoise is moving at 10 meters per second. Okay, this is just to make things easier, all right? So let's build this table here, where we have the position of the Achilles and the position of the tortoise, okay? So when they start, Achilles is at 0 meters, and let's give this head start for the tortoise of 100 meters. When Achilles reaches 100 meters, the tortoise will be at 110. Then when Achilles reaches 110 meters, the position the tortoise was before, the tortoise will be at 111 meters. And it keeps going. When Achilles get there, the tortoise will be a little bit further, will always be ahead of Achilles. Well, let's take a look into the time now. So at time zero, that's the situation. Then for this position, we have time equals 1 second, then 1.1, 1.11, and it keeps going infinitely. So that's the first paradox. But let's take a look into another one and try to find the solutions for them. The second paradox we're going to take a look at is the arrow paradox. So the paradox is that the arrow never hits the target. But why? Well, if you think that between the arrow and the target we have a certain amount of space, alright? In order for the arrow to travel this space, it has first to travel half of this space, right? But in order to travel half of this space, half of this distance, the arrow needs to travel half of the half of this distance. And you can keep going infinitely. So the paradox is, for the arrow to hit the target, it has to travel an infinite amount of space, an infinite distance. So the paradox is that the arrow would never hit the target. But of course, in real life, we know that the arrow always hits the target. So what's happening here? How can this arrow travel this infinite amount of space and hit the target? So let's take a look now into some of the solutions for these paradoxes. So the first solution we can think about these paradoxes is a difference between can and is. It's not because something can happen, okay, that it happens in real life, right? Something can be logical, but it's not physically possible, right? And the thing is, you cannot divide time and space infinitely in real life, okay? So in our minds, of course, we can always divide the time and space. That's what we were doing into the Achilles and the arrow paradoxes, right? We were dividing time and space infinitely. And if you think about it, well, then we have those paradoxes. But actually, we cannot divide them infinitely. We have something that's called the Planck length. That's the shortest length that is possible in our universe. And also we have the Planck time. That's the limit of our time. We can divide, that's the shortest time we can have in our universe. We're not going to go through how Planck got to these numbers here, okay, that's pretty complicated, but that's a fact in physics theory, right? So physically, in real life, we cannot divide time and space infinitely. You can think this as a limit, right? As we have the speed of light. The speed of light is the fastest speed we can have in our universe. It's a limit, right? So we can, in our mind, increase the speed. Okay, we can just simply say, oh, this is traveling at 1.1 times the speed of light. But in real life, it does not happen. And that's the same for time and space. And that's why one of the reasons the paradoxes make no sense in real life. Another solution we have is a simple mathematical solution. Okay? So let's take the arrow paradox, for example. Let's assume that the distance between the arrow and the target is 2 meters, all right? And it has to travel this distance. So for the paradox, we can say that this distance here, the arrow has to travel, is a series of an infinite numbers, okay? It's this infinite sum here. So the arrow needs to travel half of this distance, which is 1, and it has to travel half of this distance, which is half, and so on and so forth. So the amount of space the arrow needs to travel, it's 1 plus half plus quarter plus 1/8 and so on until infinite, right? So for the arrow to hit the target, it needs to travel this amount, this infinite amount here. So we can do some manipulations to this series here, right? Let's divide both sides of the series by 2, okay? And if you divide both sides, we have something that looks like this, alright? But we can multiply all the numbers inside the parentheses by half. And we'll find that half of d, okay, is this amount here. So it's all the numbers again, but without the 1 before, alright? Now let's take our first series, d, and now let's subtract the second series from the first one. So we have d minus d over 2. So the result will be d over 2, right? The other half. And if you take a look here, all these terms, they cancel. It's half minus half, 1/4, minus 1 over 4, and this happens for all these infinite terms of the series, right? So the only thing that's left is 1. So we have that half of d equals 1, or d equals 2. So the thing is, if you sum all these infinite spaces here, it gets to a finite number, which is 2. So in fact, the arrow travels 2 meters. So here are some of the solutions we have for these paradoxes, okay? Remember that not because something can happen, it really happens in real life, in the real universe, okay? So that's it for today. Hope you enjoyed and see you next time.
Physics can be easy. Subscribe to our channel and learn with the geeks.